Hello viewers, so in my previous video we have discussed about algebraic expression and we have done the exercise 8b of algebraic expression. Now if you have any problem regarding that exercise, then ask me over here. So today we will start another chapter. The chapter name is data handling. That is in our syllabus, data handling. Now we are familiar with data handling. We have already done in class 8. Though we have done class 8, we can do details in this class 6 from our book, R.S. Agarwal math book of class 6. Students, again I strictly suggest you to follow R.S. Agarwal math book first. After completing R.S. Agarwal, you should go for another books, okay, reference book. First your first target should be R.S. Agarwal, mind that. So first we have to know what is data. The definition is given here. Data. The word data means information in the form of numerical figure. Here are the examples is given. Okay. Now suppose the marks obtained by 10 people of a class monthly test is given 37, 21 or respectively. So we can call the data related to the marks obtained by 10 people of a class in a monthly test. Okay. Next come to example number 2. The ages of 12 teachers in a school are given. 12 teachers in a school are given. So we can call the data related to the age of 12 teachers in a school. And from the above, we can call the data related to the marks obtained by 10 people of a class in a monthly test. Next come to raw data. The data obtained in the original form is called a raw data. Data given in the above example is called raw data. In the above examples, example 1, example 2, that is called the raw data. Next, array. Arranging the numerical figure on ascending and descending order is called an array. Ascending order and descending order. Okay, either ascending order or either descending order. That is called an array. Students, don't miss any definitions. Okay, you should cover all the definition. Definitions should come in your exam. I suggest you to do all the definition. Next come tabulation of data. Arranging the data in a symbolical form of a table is called tabulation or representation of data. Next, observation. Each numerical figure in a data is called an observation. Next, frequency of an observation. The number of times a particular observation is occurred is called a frequency. I am just telling you the definitions. Now, when I am doing the maths or when I am giving you some examples, then I will definitely show you what is this, what is tabulation, what is array, what is observation, what is frequency. Okay, so next come to statistics. One more definition. Statistics is a very important definition. It is the science deals with collection, presentation, analysis and interpretation of numerical data. So you don't miss any single definition. You have to cover all of this. Next come to the examples that is given in your R.S. Agarwal math book. Given below, the data showing the number of children, 20 families of a colony. Arrange the above data in ascending order, then put in the tabular form. So we first have to arrange this in the ascending order. Ascending order, you know, the smallest one is the first come, and then the bigger, then the biggest. Okay, accordingly. So here 1 is the smallest, so 1 comes first, after that 2, now after 3, and after, and lastly 4. So this is my arrangement, or ascending order arrangement, whatever you say. Next we have to put it in a table, so that is called the tabulation of data. So we are now going to do the tabulation of the given data. Okay, so here the tabulation of the given data is given. That is my first, in my first column, first we have to write the observation, next tally marks, next number of families, that is given here, families, that is the frequency. Okay, so actually my main table content, observation, tally marks and frequency. Now here, since its family is given, 20 families, so we have to write here that family, we have to mention here this family. Okay, now if the family is not mentioned here, so we can only write the outcomes, like the next one, the number of outcomes. Okay, so this we have to remember. Number of outcomes is not need to write, we have to write the frequency. Okay, next, so my observation, first observation of that is observation 1. Now from the above question, the given below data showing the number of children, that is one children, there are 20 family. Now one children, how many families? Now one children, five families have one children, so my tally marks is 5. Now you should have to know that this is the tally marks. We represent the 5 in tally marks like that. We are taking 4 vertical line and a cross line along this corner to this corner, otherwise this corner to this corner. Okay, that is the tally marks. Now if you have to any problem to understand tally marks, please let me know and ask me that, sir, I'm not understanding the tally mark. I will definitely help you. Next come to observation 2. So there will be 7 families of two children. So in my frequency we are taking 7, and this is the tally mark representation of 7. 5 2. Next similarly 3, 6 families. So here 6, 4, 2 families, 8 4 2. Okay, so this is the tabulation of the given data. This is called the tabulation. Next come to another example. The example is given here, dice was thrown 30 times and the following outcomes were noted. The outcomes are noted like that. Represent the error data in the form of frequency distribution table. That is called, actually this is called frequency distribution table. So you have to remember that this is frequency distribution. This is called frequency distribution table, and this is called the tabulation of data also. Now my first column is come outcomes, second column tally marks must be in the second column in every frequency distribution table, remember that. And after that the number of outcomes. Now outcome 1, that is how many times one occur in a throw of a dice. 3 times occur, so my tally marks is 3. So 6 times 2 occurs. Okay, so that means the tally marks of 2 is equal to 6. Now this is the representation of the of 6. Next 9 times 3 occurs, so this is the representation of 9 tally mark in tally marks in this is the frequency or number of outcomes. Okay, next 4, so this is the representation of 4 occurs 7 times, this is the representation of 7. Next is the representation of 2, this is the representation of 3, 6 occurs 3 times, 5 occurs 2 times. So this is main thing of the frequency distribution table of data handling. Hope you are understanding. Next come to our exercise. The exercise is exercise 22. Now I suggest you to first do question number 1. All of the definition is given from your book. You just read slowly and remind it quickly. Definition should come in the your exam. Next, for today's classwork, I am suggesting you that you should do question number 2, question number 4. Okay, question number 4 and question number 3. So question number 1 and question number 5-6, this is your homework. Okay, now if you are not able to solving question number 2 and 3 2 3 4, then let me know. First, I am giving you the hint how to solve it. You first arrange all this data. Here is given the number of children in the families of a colony are given below. So this is similar to this example 1. So we have to write the observation, next tally marks, next number of families. Okay, now we are arranging this according. Next step is to arrange this in ascending order. So we have to arrange this and ascending order. So now after arranging the ascending order, it is easier to fill the table. Next, the sale of shoes of a variety size of a shop on a particular day is given below. Now so we have to make the column. That the sale of shoe of the various size of shop. So we have to write from question number, for question number 3, we have to write the size of shoe, tally marks, and number of shoe. That is, first size of shoe, that 6, we have to write 6. Then 6 is occurred here, 1, 2, 3, 4 times, I think. 1, 2, 3, and 4 times. So, my tally mark should be 4. Okay. And number of shoe is 4. Or we have to write the frequency in bracket number of shoe is equal to 4. So, that's why we have to represent that. Next, construct a frequency distribution table of the following. Only we have to write the frequency distribution table. That is, first come my outcome, next tally marks, next frequency. Or first we have to take observation, tally marks, and frequency. First column, observation, tally marks, and frequency. So in this way we can complete these two three maths, and rest of maths we have to do in your homework. Now, in which copy you have to do this? Okay, so you have to do this in your algebra copy. Okay, now that's it for today's session. For next session, keep watching my channel and please do subscribe my channel for more updates. Thanks for watching.